So what is the difference between asynchronous Byzantine and other kinds of Byzantine? Yes, so sadly, Byzantine fault tolerance means very, very strong. Except over the decades, people have said, yeah, okay, I'm Byzantine in some other sense. So now we have a million different definitions of Byzantine. The original, strongest form of Byzantine is a bunch of people, none of whom trust each other, are all trying to come to agreement on a yes-no question, and we have to come to a moment when I know we've reached a decision. I have to eventually decide yes or no. Not only that, once I have decided yes or no, I can never change my mind. It has to be an irrevocable decision. Not only that, I have to have a mathematical guarantee that we'll all reach the same decision. And it has to be one of the decisions that was in the realm of possibility. It was an answer that one of us had to begin with. And so I have to not just become more and more sure over time, or not just eventually reach a consensus, but not know that I've reached a consensus. Byzantine fault tolerance means I'm going to reach consensus, and I'm going to know I've reached consensus, and I'll know that I know, and I know it's mathematically guaranteed that we all agree. And for the strongest forms, we want to be able to prove it, even if almost a third of us are dishonest and are cheating and are breaking the rules and are doing the wrong things. And even if the attacker controls the entire internet, the wires connecting every pair of people are controlled by the attacker. And the only rule is, if I keep sending you messages, they can delete as many as they want, but eventually one of them has to get through. That's the asynchronous. Asynchronous means I'm not making any assumptions about timing. So asynchronous Byzantine means that I make no assumptions about, well, whenever I send you a message, it'll get there within 5 seconds. I don't have to make any assumptions like that. Or if I send you a message, it'll get there within X seconds, and everybody's message will get there within X seconds, and I don't even know what X is, but there is an X. That's an assumption people would make. That's partially asynchronous. Totally synchronous, not at all asynchronous, would mean, well, the whole internet works in lockstep. But what we want is truly asynchronous, which means we don't make any assumptions. We're assuming that the bad guys control the entire internet. They don't just have a malicious firewall halfway between us. They have firewalls everywhere between every pair of people in every possible pattern. They completely control the internet, and almost a third of us are malicious doing bad things. If you can prove that you have this strongest form of Byzantine agreement, even in those assumptions, then you have achieved fully asynchronous Byzantine. That's the strongest thing you can do. Unfortunately, all the systems out there that are being deployed have something far weaker. Maybe it's this partially asynchronous where you have to assume something about the timing. Well, that's okay, right? When I send a message over the internet, it probably gets there within 5 seconds or within 5 hours or you know, something like that. Can't we assume that? No. If you're assuming that, you're assuming that there's no such thing as a distributed denial of service attack. You're assuming there's nothing like a botnet in the real world. Because if I'm an honest person and I try to send you a message, but attackers are flooding me with packets from compromised computers all over the internet, and they prevent me from sending you that message, we've just violated the partially asynchronous assumption. So this very mild assumption about timing limits is actually an assumption that nobody will ever attack you with a botnet, ever. That botnets don't exist. And so what they're saying is, we give you really strong guarantees as long as there's no botnets in the world. Sadly, there are botnets in the world. So what you really want is asynchronous Byzantine. And then there's other papers, like there's a paper that's famous, very famous, where they say, we assume that some of the people are bad guys, but the bad guys never talk to each other. All of our theorems require that, you know, the bad guys never talk to each other. They're bad guys. They're going to talk to each other. I can't say, hey guys, new rule, you're not allowed to talk to each other. Are they going to follow my new rule? They're bad guys. Okay. So we don't want to make all these different assumptions. We want to have asynchronous Byzantine. This is the gold standard. And this is what Hashgraph does. And I think it's important. And Hashgraph has very detailed mathematical proofs with lemmas and theorems laid out with definitions, everything clearly defined, mathematically, rigorously. This is what we have. And we're even going down the route of formal methods that we can talk about if you're interested. But this is what we have to prove that we are asynchronous Byzantine. And I think everyone needs to start doing proofs. The world needs to have these strong proofs, and we need to have ledgers that have this strong security.